Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.1, Problem 4. This is section 2.1, problem number 4. It says, for each of the following, determine if a pie chart would be appropriate or not appropriate for summarizing the data. Pie chart isn't always appropriate. You can use it for a lot of things, but sometimes it's not appropriate. So the first one, A, the number of students registered at each of BCC's campus locations. That would be okay. I think I've even seen a pie chart for this. So, you know, you could certainly have a pie chart, and, you know, like a lot of them would be the Fall River campus, and then, you know, Taunton, New Bedford would split it up somewhat. So I would say that that's appropriate. The next one, the state a student was born. Oh, that would make a decent pie chart too. So, you know, most of the, you know, big chunk of it would be Massachusetts, and then the next biggest would be Rhode Island. And then the others would be split up, and a lot of states you wouldn't have any students from, so that would be okay. I would say that that's also appropriate. Forgotten R and the other appropriate. If a student is registered to vote or not, yeah, that'd be appropriate. In theory, it might be half and half, you know, registered, not registered. But in theory, it might be more not registered and registered, or hopefully it'd be the other way around, but I don't know if everybody really registers. But bottom line, it would make a good pie chart, and the pie chart would be appropriate for measuring that. Part D, the type of vehicle owned by a student, car, truck, SUV, or motorcycle. On the surface, it seems like it'd be pretty reasonable. You could make the pie chart, split it up, but for certain students who might, say, have a car and a motorcycle, you're kind of double-dipping into certain categories, and it might not work out very accurately. So that's what can get you into trouble with a pie chart, when you either have percents that won't add up to 100%, like certain categories are missing, or certain categories get double counted. So program of study for a student, whether it's general studies, criminal justice, business transfer, or, you know, whatever other program we have, that would make a pie chart. I think I've even seen those pie charts. So a big chunk of our students are general studies. The next biggest is criminal justice, and it's business transfer, and then it splits up into, you know, smaller ones, engineering, whatnot. So program of study that students are currently in would be appropriate. And finally, the last one, a student's ancestry of Portuguese, French, English, Spanish, or whatnot. That would also work out. I've seen those. You can go to a place like ancestry.com, and they can say that, you know, you are half Portuguese, one quarter French, and then a few other things for any one particular student. That would be okay. So that is appropriate. So the only one that would get you into trouble, because you can be in too many categories at the same time, some students might have all of these, would be the type of vehicle they drive.